Hi folks, this is Abnash here. Today I'm going to show how you can make mead, the wine of the Vikings, which is popularized so favorably by Asterix and Obelix in the Asterix series, where they drink mead at opportune moments to get the super strength to bash the Vikings. But before we begin, a quick fun look at how mankind discover alcohol.
This chimpanzee stumbles across a windfall of overripe plums. Many of them have split open, drawing him to their intoxicating fruity odor. He gorges himself and begins to experience some strange effects. This unwitting ape has stumbled on a process that humans will eventually harness to create beer, wine, and other alcoholic drinks. The sugars in overripe fruit attract microscopic organisms known as yeasts. As the yeasts feed on the fruit sugars, they produce a compound called ethanol, the type of alcohol in alcoholic beverages.
Early fermenting days. You see those two distinguished gentlemen? They're about to invent the hangover. So one guy says, "Dang, look at all these rotten grapes that ended up all over the ground. Guy, you were on Grape Watch." His bud is like, "They're just a little squishy and moldy, no biggie." They eat the grapes, get a funny head rush, and a smarter person comes along and says, "Just drink that mess, guys. Run the grape gunk through my hat and mash it up good."
So that was a fun way of how humans discovered alcohol, and the world has changed ever since then. Now let's get on to making our first batch of mead, which you can follow with the instructions given at the end of this video. First step, get some raw honey, mix it with water, simmer for some time, cool it down to room temperature. Separately, make a yeast starter and mix it with this honey water mix. Close the container and put it in a dark cold storage for about 3 weeks, and the honey is ready. So let's see the details of how this works. To make mead, you need a container, preferably a glass container or even a plastic one with a lid. The one shown here has a safety valve in the lid, used mainly for pickling, so that it allows gases from within to go out, but nothing from outside to get in. Even if you don't have something like this, but a plain old liquor bottle of 2 liters or so, or a plastic container, that's fine. Along with it, we need a pot in which we will measure about 260 grams of raw honey. Raw honey is preferred as against the usual bottled honey, which is available because it is more flavorful. However, if you can't get raw honey, go ahead and use the favorite brand that you prefer. Next, we measure out 1/2 liter of water and pour it in the pot which contains the raw honey. We also calibrate the container that we are using with 1 liter by pouring 1 liter of water in it and marking it with a tape, and thereafter pouring out the water. The water which has been put into the pot is put on a burner, and we simmer this, not boil, but probably around 70 to 80 degrees when the impurities which are there in the honey will come up as scum, which you remove with the tea strainer as shown in the picture here. After that, about 15 minutes, you take the pot out of water and pour the contents into the glass container and let it cool down to room temperature. To make the yeast starter, take a tall glass, typically a beer glass for example, pour 50 milliliters of boiled cooled water or RO water and 1 teaspoon of sugar into it. Then measure out 1 teaspoon of baking yeast, preferably Angel brand, which allows good alcohol tolerance and is a very fast fermentation yeast. Pour it into the glass and mix it with a spoon. Let this glass now rest for about 15 minutes till a creamy foam forms as shown in the picture. Pour this mixture into the container containing the honey water mix and then loosely close the lid of the container or put an aluminium foil so that the gases can escape from the container and nothing remains trapped. Next morning, you can see the gas carbon dioxide happily escaping through the safety valve. And even if you don't have a lid of this type, you can see the bubbles forming at the surface of the liquid inside the container. What you need to do is that for every day, for the first 6 days, just shake the bottle so that the yeast mixes up properly and continues to ferment happily. After 6 days, just let it rest, and over time, after a total duration of 3 weeks, you will see an absolutely clear liquid formed with all fermentation activities stopped and the layer of yeast at the bottom. At that point, you need to decant the clear liquid into another clean vessel which has been rinsed with . Now that the mead or honey wine is ready, like any other wine that is made, wines age and taste better and better over time. So you got two choices. One is that you can take the mead, pour it into a glass bottle or a soda water bottle and let it rest for about 2 to 3 weeks before consuming it. Of course, you can taste and enjoy even the young mead. There's absolutely no problem with it. Even a few sips of it will immediately give a nice, decent high. Now, for carbonation, what you do is you take an empty soda water bottle, pour 1 teaspoon of normal sugar into it, and fill the bottle, leaving half inch to 1 inch gap at the top. Close the lid firmly and put this bottle in a cool, dark place, such as the same cupboard where you had originally fermented the mead. After 2 weeks, the bottle will become rock hard because the yeast in the mead will eat up the sugar and release carbon dioxide, which will carbonate the drink which is there. End result, after 2 weeks, chill it and pour into a glass and enjoy some lovely sparkling mead. So folks, how did you like our mead project? Here are the detailed instructions for the entire process that we followed. The things that you need, followed by the preparation of the must, which is the simmering of the honey water mixture on a burner, followed by making the yeast starter, which is mixed into the honey water mix, and then the fermentation activity that we do, making sure that you don't create a bottle bomb. And once the mead is ready, you bottle it in any of the two options which are